Tritonet is a musical calculator, allows you to learn music theory based on intuition and the sense of direction. Inside Ableton Live, it additionally gives an ability to control the scalar objects dynamically throughout the entire set, thus allowing users to design the harmonic structure of their music. Before starting the walkthrough video, please make sure you install the font. Unfortunately, as of May 2022, Macs for Live devices do not support font embedding, so you need to do this installation manually. You can find the relevant font file on the Tritonet website, also with the installation file. When you install Tritonet, you should be able to see the lesson file on the right side of the Ableton window. Please click the lesson file and load the Ableton set and experiment with it. You can change the tonality of your entire set. Also, you can apply chord progressions into your music. Here is how. Tritonet consists of three devices: master, MIDI, and resonator. The best way to incorporate Tritonet into your workflow is to save the devices first into your user library. Moreover, saving the default MIDI track settings including Tritonet MIDI would be the best solution to ensure every MIDI track will have an instance as soon as it is instantiated. Tritonet Master is the brain of the harmonic network system. You need only one instance per Ableton set. You can access the main window by clicking on the circle on the device. You can also map a key by pressing the key switch in the upper right-hand corner of the live screen. This will allow you to hide and show the main screen whenever you need to access it. Tritonet Master has two sections. Left side shows the circle of fifths with additional components on it, acting like a compass for music theory. From this view, you can visualize your harmony and also send MIDI data by clicking on the notes. The right side of the window contains information about the overall harmonic location, current harmonic position, chord signs, and the control window. There are two tabs on the control window, in and out. From the in tab, you can activate the input, search, and chord sections, and also change the mapping style. The mapping style has two types, simple and advanced. Simple maps the scale notes to the entire MIDI instrument. This can be useful to stay in the scale if you are using randomization on pitches. Advanced, on the other hand, maps the in scale notes to the white keys, while the out scale notes to the black keys. This is beneficial while performing in order to get out of the scale and come back easily. The input tab allows you to choose the incoming scale and the root note. By default, it is based on D Dorian, which allows users to think about symmetry while using their MIDI keyboards. Quick note, Tritonet also switches Ableton Push to D Dorian automatically. When you activate the input tab, you can specify the incoming scale and root. This can be useful if you would like to incorporate Tritonet into your old set or use MIDI files from the internet. The search tab allows you to explore the library and submit queries from over 300 modes. There are a couple of ways for searching. You can either write on the search box to find the scale, or you can use the knob to find the scale according to their containing number of tritone pairs. Question mark button starts listening to your playing. As soon as you clear the keyboard, it gives you the result. The quarter tab allows you to create four note chords with a single key, in SATB style. This section also distributes the chord information to the Tritonet MIDI devices, so you can design your chord progressions. The arpeggio button allows you to change position when the note is repeated. Quadral switches from triadic chords to quadral chords. The chord type knob allows you to choose the chord type. You can also choose how Tritonet is going to interpret your key input. Soprano interacts as the key presses the highest note in the chord, while the bass is the opposite, the lowest note in the chord. Using soprano would be useful if you have a melody and you would like to create chords that go along with it. On the out tab, you can control the outgoing scale. Top left corner is the outgoing MIDI root note. This is the gravitational center of your music. Then you have the emojis, representing the seven natural modes: Lydian, Ionian, Mixolydian, Dorian, Aeolian, Phrygian, and Locrian. The slider down the emojis allows you to travel to the other scales related to chosen mode. The relation is based on sharing the same tritone pair, thus containing the same mood. three toggles on the upper right side of the Out tab are built for performance purposes. The minus toggle is for the negative harmony, inverting the intervals of the mode on the axis of the root note. The cross toggle is for the cross harmony, transposing the root note to the relative tritone. The dice toggle randomly picks a root and a mode, and it goes back to the original mode when it is off. Second device of the network, Tritonet MIDI, is used to control the MIDI tracks harmonically. It contains a scalar, Tritonet MIDI device and a couple useful stock MIDI effects, grouped into a rack. The top left macro controls the behavior of the Tritonet MIDI device. You can switch in between five different harmonic zones. First one is the neutral, which does not get affected by the chord changes. The next four are bass, tenor, alto and soprano respectively. When you switch to one of these, you will get a dynamic change on the scale object for each chord you are producing. Please note that they switch to the neutral by default if the quarter is off in Tritonet Master. Also keep in mind, if you would like to use more MIDI effect devices, make sure Tritonet MIDI is at the end of the chain to ensure consistent tonality. Third device controls the stock resonator module of Ableton Live. This rack holds resonator and the control device. First macro allows you to change the octave of the resonator. Second macro allows you to travel inside the mode. The other tabs natively control the resonator module. This device actually opens a new door by adding resonant signals to your audio files, soundscape recordings, drums, speech and vocals. If turn the decay and dry/wet macros full, you can create soundscapes. By using halfway, it almost acts like an auto-tune without enforcement. Using a slight addition can keep the original signal but helps to resonate with the rest of the music. For more information about harmony, please refer to the music theory videos provided on the website and the YouTube channel.